Many trials in America are now videotaped in their entirety. What you're about to see is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Or at least, the truth according to the people involved. Newport is a charming little town on the southernmost tip of Rhode Island, the smallest state in America. It's famous for jazz festivals, the America's Cup, and an enclave of millionaires' palaces, quaintly referred to as summer cottages. In this one, once used for the setting of the movie High Society, lived the Von Bulows. One day, early in 1981, it was the scene of some unusual activity. Claus von Bülow had been indicted for attempting to murder his wife, Martha. Universally known as Sunny, she had left her first husband, Prince Alfie von Auersberg, for Claus, a Danish aristocrat of limited means. She brought with her $34 million and a 14-room apartment on New York's Fifth Avenue. Now she was lying in this hospital, in a coma that doctors said was irreversible. And the state of Rhode Island charged that Claus had sent her there with an injection of insulin. He was to face trial in Newport.
The Honorable Superior Court, the Honorable Judge Newton presiding.
Your name, please.
Claus von Bülow.
Your address?
960 Fifth Avenue, New York City.
Your date of birth?
11th of August, 1926.
You are charged with two counts. Count one, assault with intent to commit murder. Count two, assault with intent to murder. How do you plead?
I am not guilty.
State ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor. The state is ready to proceed.
Defendant ready to proceed?
Yes, we are, Your Honor.
You may be seated.
They will prove was a clandestine, subtle, and ingenious attempt on the part of her husband, Claus von Bülow, to terminate her life, to murder her, by secretly injecting her with a drug called insulin.
The case quickly attracted mass media attention. The defendant reflected on why.
I think there are certain aspects, like the aura of the name Newport that, for instance, attracted this as opposed to many other resorts. My wife's first marriage gives it a certain cuteness. My work in years past for Mr. Getty gives it a certain interest.
He could have added that it had all the ingredients of a soap opera: money, sex, drugs, and suspense. So much so that it was destined to become a Hollywood film, Reversal of Fortune, starring Glenn Close as Sonny and Jeremy Irons as Claus von Bülow, a part that was to win him an Academy Award.
On December 27th, 1979, I lay in bed all day. Whether I was asleep or in a coma later became a subject of dispute.
Uta Hagen played the part of Sonny's maid, Maria.
What did you do?
I came downstairs. And Mr. von Bülow said that Madame had a very sore throat and I didn't have to do any work and she was in bed all day.
What are you doing? Did we ring for you?
She's ice cold. Mrs. von Bülow.
Leave her alone. She's sleeping. She was drinking last night. We didn't get any rest.
She's not sleeping. She's unconscious. You must call a doctor.
Maria. Go on.
A half hour later, she had not moved. I went back and forth all morning.
When my breathing became obstructed,
Maria!
My husband, Claus von Bülow, finally did as my maid had been urging all day. He summoned a physician.
Dr. Poltese?
I stopped breathing. My heart stopped beating. By this time, I was certainly in a deep coma, from which I awoke several hours later. By the next morning, I was myself again. This first coma aroused suspicion and fear in the minds of my personal maid, Maria, my son, Alex, and my elder daughter, Alla. From this time on, though they never voiced their suspicions to me, they kept a vigilant eye on Klaus.
In the real-life trial, Maria was the first witness, the maid who had the earliest suspicions of her employer's husband. There were two comas, both at Christmas time. She had seen Sonny in the first.
And I went to her, and I saw that her right arm was hanging out of the bed. And I took her arm, and the arm was ice cold. She hardly could breathe anymore, and I thought she would stop any minute now breathing.
It was Maria who had found the most crucial piece of evidence, a little black bag in Klaus's closet. She showed it to Alexander, the son of the first marriage.
And there was a bottle of insulin added, a syringe and needles. I called Alexander, he was home, and I called him.
And
I showed, yes, he did.
Did you show him what you had found?
Yes.
Do you recall what you said to Alexander at that time?
Well, I was handing the insulin bottle, and I said, insulin for what? Insulin.
But she refused to reply to intimate questions about Madame, such as, had Sonny had her face lifted?
I'm not going to answer the question because I promised Mrs. von Bülow.
After his mother lapsed into her permanent coma, Alexander went to a lawyer, Richard Koo, a former district attorney of Manhattan. Koo hired a private detective who took the black bag from Klaus's closet and had the contents analyzed. Koo passed the results to Rhode Island State Police. That led to the arrest of Klaus.
Ampules in little plastic packaging, and hypodermic needles.
Uncle Klaus, as the children had called him, watched the stepson he had brought up since the age of 7. The defense lawyers claimed that the search was illegal and prejudiced the whole of the state's case. But the judge overruled their motion for dismissal.
And I will deny the omnibus motion to dismiss the indictment because of private prosecution.
His decision was later to be challenged. Klaus's stepdaughter, Princess Annie Laurie Kneisel, known as Alla, testified to her suspicions.
We knew that there was a pouch in a metal box in my stepfather's closet containing a needle which then turned out to have insulin and amibarbital on it. There were several other things that had led to suspicions. Everything put together made us believe that we had to go to the police.
And to the reasons for Sunny wanting a divorce that would have cut Klaus off from her money.
She felt he was on the verge of a nervous breakdown, that he was blaming her for the fact that he'd been having no success in his professional life.
Alla challenged her stepfather.
I then asked him about Alexandra Isles specifically. He told me that there had been a relationship. This relationship was it was a friendship at that particular point in time.
Enter the girlfriend, Alexandra Isles. Question. Did you know that Mr. von Bülow was suspected of killing his wife?
I thought it was a pack of nonsense.
You still think it's a pack of nonsense?
I don't know.
I didn't hear that answer.
I don't know.
Did you give Mr. von Bülow an ultimatum in terms of when the marriage should take place?
I said, would 6 months be suitable? We're talking about in March or April. I felt he'd be, just for himself, that he would have been happier and had a better life in making that break. He asked me to marry him again, and he said that he would go to the telephone, he would call